Cruz Aliano on the tenor saxophone there. Shane Gearing from the clarinet. Cole Q back there on the trumpet. Ryan Eaton on the piano. There's going to be a lot of solos, hopefully I announce them all. Hey, Cruz, who you been listening to, by the way? Right?
Stan Getz,
all right. So he's inspired. He sometimes sends me late night texts. You gotta check this out. It'll change your life. So we appreciate that. So our next tune is a Neil Hefti and Count Basie tune. Actually, the last one is Basie. When we say Ellington, the Ellington competition, I'll tell you a little bit more about this, has been sort of this pipe dream of ours, this idea of putting ourselves on a big stage. You know, they say, how do you get to Carnegie Hall? Well, practice. In New York, all the best bands are invited to New York in May based on a recording that they do. And we've done one for the last 8 or so years. And I know we haven't made it yet, but this band and versions of this band have grown over the years, chasing this idea of being our best selves, but also seeing other players, other high schoolers, young folks that play on another level. So to see somebody that's your age that's A, kicking your butt, but B, you know, playing music and falling in love and being inspired with this art, with jazz. So I really appreciate these folks for buying into this and digging this music. So this next tune is actually a Count Basie tune, still in that early swing music tradition. It's called Little Darla. And we're gonna feature over here Shire Engel.
Thank you.
for our last number, before we bring out our special guest, we're going to do one more swing tune here. And this is in the Ellington style. Many of these tunes have been played by every band. And in our research to transcribe and learn this, we find gypsy jazz, and we find, you know, Duke Ellington, Count Basie has a great recording of this as well. So this is a tune called Topsy, and again, we got some solos thrown around, so we hope you enjoy. probably forgot somebody, but that's okay. All right. So we have a couple minutes here. We're going to change over, and then I'll actually introduce our special guest. So it's not a formal intermission, but we'll take about 3 or 4 minutes to move a few things around and bring up our next guest. So talk amongst yourselves. We'll be right back. We're back. So that was our set, but this next tune really has been one of the more challenging pieces we've taken on. It was written for, or I should say, it was written by a professor at University of Idaho and percussion guru, Dan Bukvich, wrote this for this specific performance, and there's a few performances I'll actually let our guest talk about that. This was written for, you know, a competent jazz band. We had to learn how to count to 14/8. Not just 1, 2, 3, 4. So you're gonna hear some multimeter stuff, you're gonna hear some dance music, really great lush harmonies, and so we've had to step up our game on this, and these folks really have eaten it up. You give them great music and they rise to the occasion, and more importantly for us to share the stage with this next person, it's an honor and a privilege for me. He approached me in the spring or summer, said, hey, we're gonna be doing this thing, do you want to be a part of it? We'd love to be able to bring it to this stage. He performed this a couple weeks ago, and I think this, he'll tell you whether this is his third or fourth or second performance, but we're happy to share in this tradition and be not the premiere, but close to the premiere of Three Brazilian Dances for solo flute and jazz band by Dan Bukvich. And our guest tonight is a solo, or I should say, the flute professor from University of Idaho and the assistant director of the School of Music, Lionel Hampton School of Music. Please welcome to the stage Dr. Leonard Garrison. He brought all his flute toys. And I'm before he gets set up here. While he gets set up, I do want to thank our flutists in the crowd. We have some younger musicians that I invited, and we have some sixth graders, seventh graders, some younger flutes. And of course, Shire has been inspired. I know has had some time with Dr. Garrison over the years. So for us to carry that tradition and bring the flute to the jazz band, I think in a way that you know, we don't always get a chance to hear it. So as soon as he's ready, turn the microphone over to him, and he'll tell you about all the variety of instruments he brought with him.
Turn
it
up just a little.
Well, the honor is all mine. So Dan Bukvich and I have offices next to each other in the School of Music. And so we talk about 6 or 7 times a day about all kinds of things. And a couple of years ago, I said, what a shame it was that there was only one piece for solo flute and jazz band And so he got right to work, and which is a little strange because I have no expertise in jazz at all. I'm a totally classically trained player. But the idea as he started working on this was to write it for me to play with jazz, high school jazz bands in the area. And he kind of overshot the bar here. And a lot of the bands looked at the score and said, no way. Your director here is fantastic musician, is fearless. And he said, sure. And of course the band stepped up. It's a very So as he was saying, it's very rhythmically complex and there are lots of challenges, but it's a great piece because it's the perfect balance between the soloists. You'll hear plenty of me, but you'll hear plenty of them too. They get to shine. So that's terrific. And I did want to explain, Dan knows that I love to play all the flutes. So you know what a flute looks like. You'll also hear the piccolo. And this one's called the alto flute. And my big mama, bass flute. Okay. So all four figure in, and it's so well written for all the instruments. So again, this is it's a distinct pleasure, and please enjoy.
Thank you. Garrison, everybody. Yeah. The Charter Academy, Red Hot Jazz Band.